Come on, don't be shy. Open up your mouth, say ah. Don't be shy, open up and say ah. Like ah, then you do it now. Say ah, say ah. Don't say ah. Hello, is it me you're looking for? It's your girl, Miss Chet, and welcome to Vocalfy. Ah, get it. Today's topic is the last stop on club vocal track. We are talking about the oral cavity or your mouth. It is the most recognizable thing because that's where the sound comes out of, and that's the thing that your vocal teacher always tells you. Drop your jaw, just drop it. Just put your jaw down, just do it. And I know you're like, girl, what are you talking about? I am dropping my jaw, why you keep asking me that? Well, here's why I'm telling you that your jaw is probably not dropped far enough to get the resonant sound that you like. Let's get into it. So according to the Googles, the oral cavity includes the lips, the inner lining of the lips for your gums, your cheeks, teeth, and the front two-thirds of your tongue and the floor of your mouth below the tongue. Also includes your hard and your soft palate. Ideally, as a singer, you wanna have a clean opening all the way straight through from the back of your mouth, back of your throat, to the front of your mouth. You might hear singers saying, oh, I'm not getting loud enough, or their sound is very muted. It's probably because the back of the throat is closed off a bit and there's a smaller space for the sound to resonate and travel. Oh my gosh, I almost forgot. If you like what you are hearing and you think this information is valuable, give your girl a like. Give your girl a subscribe. Like, what we doing, right? What we doing? Anyways, so in true vocal club fashion, if the oral cavity was a place, it would be the part of the club where the dance floor is at, where the general population is moving and shaking, where we are sweating, dancing shoulder to shoulder, bumping drinks on the person next to you and getting into fights. Corona, I know, we can't do that anymore. So how do we know if we are using the oral cavity? Well, similar to the exercise we did in the nasal cavity, if you say, hi, my name is Miss Chance. And if I pinch my nose, hi, my name is Miss Chance. And the sound is drastically different, then I am no longer in the oral cavity. The sound should be exactly the same whether I pinch my nose or not. Hi, my name is Crystal Chance. Hi, my name is Crystal Chance. Slight variance, but for the most part, it sounded the same. That means that all my air was being directed through the oral cavity. So how do we create space in the oral cavity? Here's some exercises that you can do to loosen up the face, to loosen up the mouth.